You are no longer a constitutionalist. You cannot consider yourself a small government constitutionalist if you believe in gun control and infringement. We're not talking about, look, I have no problem if you are deemed dangerous after you've had the chance to testify. You are innocent until proven guilty. We cannot cross this line. You are innocent until proven guilty. The red flag law says some accuser can go to court and say, you know what? They're very, very dangerous. They're very dangerous. I've been, look, I was married to them for a very long time. And the threats, oh, you would not believe the threats that they're making. You don't think vengeance, just pettiness would get involved? You don't think that there's someone in your family, perhaps not, maybe you're lucky. I know in my extended family, I would not count it out that somebody in my extended family or relations would say, oh yeah, I was at a family reunion. The guy's unstable. Oh, he's absolutely unstable.
You could have people sitting at this desk with you that would make claims like that to courts. I mean,
if you've ever been through a horrible divorce.
Oh, my God.
You don't even have to go. You could go to one of the brothers or sisters or uncles or aunts or anybody else that just was angry.
Why was Barack Obama our president? Why? Well, he won a Senate race in Illinois. Why did he win the Senate race in Illinois? Well, he was in a very tight race against Jack. I want to say Jack Ryan, but that's the character, right?
Yeah.
Who was the guy? I can't remember his name. Ryan was his last name, who went through a very nasty divorce with an actress who, in the divorce proceedings, accused him of all sorts of crazy stuff that somehow Barack Obama's people got unsealed. And then eventually his opponent, Obama's opponent, had to drop out of the race. It is Jack Ryan. Thank you.
Does it end up to be true?
I don't think so. Obviously wasn't there. And afterwards, you know, after the divorce happened, there was a cooling off period and, oh, well, he's not that person
so
and blah, blah, blah.
You're going through a divorce.
This happens all the time.
Your husband loves guns. Mm-hmm. And you want to bilk him for everything, every penny he's got, okay? That's not an unheard of scenario.
Mm-hmm.
And because you're being pushed by the attorneys, you're angry, whatever it is. You're telling me that America, you can't see a husband or a wife, doesn't matter.
Yeah.
Say, you know what? You're going to give this to me or I'm going to talk about your guns.
It's objectively worse the other way, right? Let's say a woman is maybe having an affair and the guy's very angry about it and she has a gun to protect herself against an angry man. And the man goes and says, you know what? She's nuts. She's been threatening people. I think my children are in danger. Go take her guns. They go do that. Then she's vulnerable from him, right? I mean, it's a terrible thing, and we've tried this red flag law thing out recently on another issue. It's called Me Too accusations.
Where we've
just been like,
except,
you know what? Yeah,
No.
Take all their power away, take their jobs away, throw them out of society, and then we'll figure out whether they actually did it or not.
But then this, what makes this worse is that's not involving the government or the court system.
Right, that's just public opinion.
This is public opinion.
And
that's bad enough. This one is saying, no, we deem you guilty mm-hmm. before you even have a chance to answer the charge.
Yeah. And it's your reputation being of high quality is not a constitutional right. People can say have all sorts of terrible opinions about you. I don't know if you've noticed that some people have terrible opinions about you even, Glenn.
Wait, what?
It's true. But, you know, constitutional right is your right to bear arms. So we're taking away a constitutionally guaranteed thing with no, I mean, because like red flag laws already exist. Red flag laws are when you go and you say, hey, you know, we need to get this person is really erratic and he's acting, and we need to have him committed, right? Involuntary commitment.
Mm-hmm.
These things already exist. The only thing that the new brand of red flag laws does is it makes it so they take the guns before they figure it out.
Yeah.
Right.
This is like,
I don't know if he's crazy. Let's just take the guns and then we'll figure it out and see if it's true. That's insane.
Craziness.
It's upside down.
That is craziness. That is against everything we stand for. This is you remember, you're taking away a person's right to be innocent before guilty. What you're doing is you're starting down this slippery slope that, look, things happen, so we're going to look at you as guilty, and everybody will know you're guilty, and we're going to take your guns. And good luck getting them back, by the way. We're going to take your guns. But if you prove yourself to be responsible, excuse me? Personally, I think that is civil war. I think these red flag laws.
They're very popular, though. I mean,
they
poll very well.
Then maybe not.
I don't think people understand exactly what they are.
I don't think so either.
You know, and it's like, you know, you have a situation where the research on the red flag laws where they've been implemented shows no effect on homicide rate. It shows a very slight effect on suicide rate. And we've seen, you know, some of these states, we're talking about a third of cases are later found out to be frivolous. A third? You're taking away the constitutional right from a third of the people you're accusing? You can't do that. That is not an American principle whatsoever. I know we really, like, we all have these people around us that are like, oh man, that guy seems dangerous.
This is why
most of those people don't go out and shoot people.
This is why I am not for the death penalty. It's not because of life. Innocent life. I'm opposed to taking innocent life. Mm-hmm. And that is why I'm torn on the death penalty, but have finally come down on the death penalty. I'm against it because we can make mistakes.